Hello friends, Kishan is here again and welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video we are going to look how to implement a Spring Boot custom security with database. So in previous video tutorial we have seen how to perform a Spring security with in-memory database, right? So in this video tutorial user related information will store into the database, like a user name, password, a role, etc. We will store in the password, and from we will store in the database, and from database we will authenticate and authorize them, right? So this project I have already created. So to save some time, this project I have already created. In this project we have a lot of files and folders. So let me explain you this project first of all. So first of all, I'll go through the pom.xml. In pom.xml, as usual, tillet we have created. So first of all, we have a parent which shows that our project is the children of this project. Now in dependency we have added dependency for a Spring Boot starter dev. So we have implemented some REST API, so that's what we have added is the dependency. Again, we have added dependency for the Spring Boot starter security. So this will add Spring security related jars in our class path. That's what we have added this dependency. We have used Spring Boot starter data JPA. We are using Spring Boot data, so that's what. And we are using MySQL, so MySQL database dependency we have added. Finally, we have added dev tools. So if we make any change in our source code, once we save, then server will be started automatically. That's what we have added Spring Boot dev tools. And finally, we have a plugin which helps us to generate executable jar and var files. That's all about this pom.xml. Now in application dot properties we have a database related, like driver name, database URL, username, password. So here specifying this driver class name is optional, but these three property will have to specify, like database URL, username and password. Some of the properties I have declared for the Tomcat connection pool, so these are the self-explanatory, and rest of the properties are related to the Spring JPA, right? So Hibernate JPA related properties, right? So that's all about this properties file. And I have created two SQL file which is under the resources folder, schema.sql, which basically creates our database table in our database, right? That is a Spring Security DB. So here this table is already there, so I'm going to truncate this table. Basically I'm going to clean up this table, I'm going to delete all data from this table. So let's truncate. So all rows I have deleted. So basically if table does not exist, then first of all table gets dropped and that is created, right? And so when we'll start this project, then Spring automatically picks this data.sql, and that will run and that will create the database table, that will drop and recreate again. And after that, Spring basically runs this data.sql. So this contains the DML query, so basically that inserts data into these two tables. So that's all about this two .sql file, right? Now we have a several files. So first we have this is a Spring Boot startup class. So this is the starting point of our class, right? Now if you look into the there is one more class which contains the main method, and purpose of this class is to generate here I have used a bcrypt password encoder class to encode the password. So in database we are going to store encoded password instead of the text password. So this helps us to generate the encoded password, right? So if I run it, then this will generate us the encoded password, like m@123 and s@123. So this is the encoded password. So when you run this class, for every run this will generate the different password. So this password will have to store into our database in users column. So this is the password. So here in this column we have to store this password, right? So this password already I have generated, and I have basically I'm just inserting through this SQL query. So look at these two passwords. So I have generated and kept it. So in every run, this will generate the different password. So that's all about this. And we have first of all, we have a controller class, and in this controller class we have a different API, and in this controller class we are using the topic service. So we are and this topic service we are using in this controller. So first of all, we have a get topic by ID, and this takes topic ID as a path param, and that calls to the service layer, and service layer basically. So this is the service layer interface. If you go to the implementation, then service layer basically talks to the DAW layer, and DAW layer talks to the database, and that basically here in database layer basically we are using Spring data JPA, and this class basically we have annotated as @transactional@repository. So the role of Spring @transactional annotation is to make DAW method transactional. We are using here JPA API for database transaction, hence we will instantiate entity manager using dependency injection. To achieve it, create entity manager property annotated with @persistent_context, right? And this entity manager we are using to interact with the database. So we have a find method, and find method takes class and as well as primary key as an argument. This returns the topic class. Similarly, we have a get all topics, and here we have written SQL. So it's pretty straightforward SQL, from topic as t is the alias and order by t dot. So basically this fetches all topic from the databases, and that returns the caller. And again we have a add topic, so basically that persists the topic in the database. And similarly we have a update topic. So to update topic, first we get topic from the database, and if we find this topic exists in the database, then we update this topic. And if topic which we want to update that does not exist in the database, then else part we are just printing topic does not exist which we want to update. Similarly, we have a delete topic. So we are taking topic ID from the client, and first we check whether this topic exists in the database or not by calling this local method. And if this topic exists in the database, then that simply we are removing from the database. If this topic doesn't exist, then control will give the else, and thus we are printing one statement. Now just we are checking in this API, we are checking whether topic exists or not by passing the title and as well as category. And here we have used the user SQL, right? And in this SQL we are passing over here, and these two parameters, first parameter title and second parameter category, these two parameters we are setting over here. If topic exists with this title and category, then count will be written as a greater than 0, then this is going to return as true, else false. So pretty straightforward this DAW class, right? Now we have another DAW class which basically talks to the database, and that returns the basically user information, right? So you can see the API get active user. This here we'll have to pass the user name, and this basically calls to the database and talks to the user info. And user info is our entity class, which is annotated as @entity, and this is binded with this table, users table, and these are the corresponding properties. And for every property we have given the column name, and we have applied some constraint, and this column represents the primary key, and that's why we have @ID. And these are the properties and corresponding column name, and there are some constraint we have applied. So pretty straightforward entity class, right? So here basically we are just checking if user exists, then corresponding user we are going to return to the caller, right? Now here, so if you go to the, we have a topic entity class as well, which is binded with the topics table. Now what I am going to do, so most important things, we have this security related stuff we have done over here. Security related classes, there are two classes which comes under the config package. First security class, we have a topic security config which extends web security configured adapter class, and here we have just trying to auto wire user Details Service (INPL), and User Details Service basically implements User Details Service which belongs to the Spring itself. And once you implement this interface is having a method is called load user by username. So we will have to override this method, and here we are passing the username, and we are interacting with the database, and we are just fetching the user information based on the username, and we are creating the granted authority. And here this user object we have created, and this user object basically belongs to the Spring framework itself. Here we are passing username, password, and authorities, list of authorities or list of roles. And finally we have typecasted into the user details, and same user details we are returning. So basically this method is getting called from, so this service class will be instantiated by the container itself, Spring container, and this method will be called automatically, right, to authenticate a user. Second security related classes we have created, topic, so sorry guys, yeah, second security related classes we have configured topic security config, which basically extends BF security configurator adapter, and there we have used we have auto wired this user service user detail service, which just we have talked, we have auto wire, and we have also auto wire this topic authentication entry, right, topic authentication entry point that extends basically this class basic authentication entry point, and we have overridden its method is called comments. So if user is user authentication gets failed, then we would like to send some proper message, and this method takes a request, HTTP request, and HTTP server response as an argument. In response we are setting some real name as well as some authentication error as well as authentication message, so that this will send response to the client. That's all about this class. And here in this topic security configuration we have overridden method is called configure. Here we are passing HTTP HTTP security as an argument, and here we are basically we are just we are calling CSRF. CSRF is called cross site request forgery, so just we are disabling that one, and we are calling authorize request, and we are just calling a method is called and matches, and here we are passing a pattern, and if user is having a role admin then or user, then they can access this kind of this kind of API which follows this pattern. And we have applied HTTP basic authentication, and realm name we have supplied over here, and finally we have passed this topic authenticator entry point as well, which we have declared over here. And we want the we have given the global, we have written one more method is called configure global like our previous example, and here we are passing authentication manager builder, and here we are using bcrypt password encoder to get the password to authenticate from the database, right? So that's all about these all classes. Now I'm going to close this all classes, and here if you look into the security, then we have a now if you look into the data, now let's run this class, main class, so that Spring Boot kicks up, and this will run the this script, and data will be populated into the database as we discuss. So now application has started. Now if you go to, now Tempad has started. Now two users is created, one is the Martin and second is the Sohn. Martin is having role as the user and Sohn is having a role as admin, right? And topic, there is three topics has been created, right? Now we are going to test every API, right? So guys, I'm running out of time, so some of the things I couldn't explain, so rest of the things I'm going to explain you in this next video tutorial. So thanks for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.